coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, all hell is breaking loose in Ukraine as pro-Russian forces battle in cities across the eastern area of that nation with the NATO-EU-backed government forces who were freedom fighters a few months ago when they were overthrowing the elected government. Now, anyone not rolling over and being enslaved by them is being called a terrorist by the U.S. and European media. And I've weighed things very judiciously here looking at it, and I have to say the West started the conflict because they wouldn't join the EU, and now they're purposefully trying to manipulate Russia into invading eastern Ukraine to protect their interests there, and it is a very dangerous, dangerous game. There's a whole other facet to this I haven't talked a lot about. They're talking about Putin having secret slush funds, which undoubtedly I'm sure he does. And when they go after Swiss bank accounts in the last decade or so, they're usually going after nouveau riche people with $5, $10, $20 million. Sounds like a lot. It's not. They're leaving alone the billionaires and the globalists. You know, it came out last year that the French socialist across the board, most of the government got caught with giant Swiss and Luxembourg and Bahamas accounts, and that they're the ones pushing a 100%+ tax. I'm not joking. On the middle class to destroy any savings they had accrued over the years. But of course they support 100% tax, like 101%, because they are above the law and don't pay those taxes. Like EU bureaucrats under law don't pay EU tax. It is incredible the level of open evil and hypocrisy they get away with. And so now that they're so above the law, they're going to go after basically other countries' leaders who've been funneling some of the state-run company money into themselves. And Putin is reportedly, from back when he was vice president under Yeltsin, owns a share of this particular energy company. And the media tries to say, you know, we bet it's $40 billion. I mean, it might be a billion. It might be $100 million. Who knows? They're using it as propaganda against him, going, we're going to take your private money, your getaway money, your gangster money, buried under the doghouse or wherever it's at. We're coming after you if you don't back off and join the New World Order. And they had a big diplomat come out last week and say, Putin's not joining the New World Order. This looks personal. This does not look like some deal behind the scenes where Russia and the West divide Ukraine, but then politically act like they're fighting and get some new multi-trillion dollar Marshall Plan for Europe. That's bare minimum that they want to claim the crisis in Europe's being caused by what's happening in Russia as a new bailout for the bankers, a new wealth transfer to them. But when you look at what's happening with this Putin situation and trying to get his money and trying to end private bank accounts globally, that's a global mafia not letting you hide your money. Let's say you want to leave the U.S. Let's say you sell a restaurant chain you've got or car dealerships or whatever. And you have got $50 million. It's all post-tax. You've paid tax on it. It took you decades to make. You put it in the Swiss bank account. It's after tax money. And you leave the U.S. Well, they're clawing that back, saying, no, we retroactively want that money. And they're really creating currency controls. And that's what the TSA is a currency control to go through your bags. And they now admit that's what their job is. Well, I don't want to live in your planet dungeon. I don't want to live in the prison planet. And that's the whole point, is the globalists are autocratic, authoritarian anti-humans who are getting rid of any wiggle room to get out from under their tyranny. Normally, they wouldn't do that because they weren't above the law completely. Now when they're above the law, welcome to tyranny, because they'll get rid of every check and balance because they're exempt. We'll be right back.
Globalist social engineers are not just targeting us with propaganda. They are manipulating our genetics. We are being targeted at every level by estrogen mimickers that lower our testosterone and other hormones and natural compounds that the body needs. After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic super male vitality formula, sourced from powerful organic herbs and then concentrated for maximum potency. Super Male Vitality was developed to activate your body's own natural processes instead of using synthetic chemicals. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose. For a limited time, we are offering 15% off Super Male Vitality at InfoWarsLife.com to introduce you to this powerful supplement. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality. InfoWarsLife.com.
General, what do you think about the FBI saying that there's a terror alert on Monday about a potential Fort Hood situation?
The police are shoving people, shoving Alex, shoving the crowd.
Here we go, folks, I'm being assaulted.
Whether it's the radio show, the news websites, documentary films, or the nightly news, InfoWars is the tip of the spear.
Is this another false flag stage attack to take our civil liberties and put more homeland security while sticking the hands down on the pants on the streets?
It's up to us to set brush fires in the minds of men and women everywhere. And that's what PrisonPlanet.tv is designed to do.
You watch, the Assad regime is going to be blamed or accused of using chemical weapons against the so-called rebels.
What we see now is a war against reality. It's a war against the truth.
It's more vital than ever that supporters of freedom become members of PrisonPlanet.tv and share their membership with up to 11 friends and family. Visit InfoWarsNews.com today. Become a member, share your membership, and help take the InfoWar to the next level. Why does the United States spend the largest percentage of GDP in the world on healthcare? Why do we have the highest cancer rates on the planet? The highest rates of diabetes, autism, and every other major disease? It all comes down to one thing. We are what we eat. Our food is devoid of nutrition and processed with poisons and additives. Our water is filled with toxic poisons and big pharma runoff. All of this has been engineered by design. We can turn the tide against the eugenicist by giving ourselves the nutrients our body desperately needs. To learn more, visit InfoWarsHealth.com. The site is literally packed with audio and video featuring top health professionals who don't bow down to big pharma. The fight against the New World Order starts with you, and you can't stand against the machine of your sick, tired, and obese. When you visit InfoWarsHealth.com, be sure and check out the catalog with nearly 400 life-changing products. And get free shipping when you sign up for AutoShip.
If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance. Live from the InfoWars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
My friends, welcome to this live Monday worldwide edition. It is the 28th day already of April 2014. I am your host, Alex Jones, and we're going to have Joseph Farah, who joined us Friday. He's here working on a film in Austin. He's going to be joining us in studio in the third hour today, and that is our only guest, Joseph Farah of WorldNetDaily.com and, of course, the Western Journalism Center. There's the headline, IRS bombshell, most audacious power play yet. In fact, give me that story, because we have another report out today on Media Matters, run by the White House, funded by George Soros, and they are openly saying that, now get this, that of course we influence the media, and of course we're trying to influence politics. But then you've got the IRS revoking tax-exempt status for mainline libertarian, conservative, and Christian pro-life groups, saying, well, you can't have a view on anything. Telling pro-life groups, you can't be anti-abortion, because that's a political issue. Absolutely over the top insane. Number one, Congress shall make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. And then it goes into the freedom of the press and the right of the people to petition their government for a redress of grievances. So it's all there, the right to assembly, the right to expression, the right to religion, the right to a free press, and Congress shall make no law respecting the establishment of religion or the free exercise thereof, or of the press, or the people's right to assemble and petition the government for redress of grievances. Government has no jurisdiction over religion. Government has no jurisdiction over the press. Government has no jurisdiction over the right of assembly. Government has no jurisdiction over the right to petition. It has no jurisdiction. I'm going to say that again. You have no jurisdiction. I don't care what your power-grabbing FCC says. I don't care what the power-grabbing federal courts say. I don't care. Now, the Ukraine situation is off the charts, okay? It's off the charts bad. The mayor of Krakow has been shot in the back while bicycling because he wasn't going along with the West. There are helicopters attacking multiple cities and tanks, explosions, death, people being shot at checkpoints by the supposed government forces and their militias. And again, they knew that when they started taking areas that were traditionally Russian, Russian ethnic enclaves, and removing those elected governments and things like that, that there would be backlash against it. So you've now got, just like in Germany, before Hitler came to power, you've got the pro-Russian street thugs, you've got the pro-EU street thugs, you've got people whose granddaddy got killed by Stalin, you got people whose granddaddy got killed by the Nazis. And so both sides hate each other going back to World War II and before that. And it is a disaster. And the globalists are playing that off against each other, just like they'll play one African tribe off against another tribe because one's Christian and one's animist, or one's Muslim and one's Christian, or one's Catholic and or one's Protestant. Or sometimes it's just an African tribe that is just across the river. And your great-great-granddaddy killed my great-great-granddaddy. So we're going to get you back. That's how tribalism works. And the globalists call it the great game. They look at the different fishers using sociologists, anthropologists, Peace Corps front people, CIA, about half of them on average. Nothing against the so-called Peace Corps set up by Kennedy, but it's a front. They send in good, well-meaning people to get everybody's trust, study the tribal divisions, the tribal beefs. They then go back and write reports up, and then that's given to the different intelligence agencies to give to private jackals, corporations as they're known. Private operators, political operators are known as jackals, economic hitmen. And then they send them in to play the groups off against each other and then act like the mediators to fix it. That's why the Southern Poverty Law Center and ADL and different federal FBI groups have been caught financing the radical left groups and financing the radical white supremacist groups. You'll have a leader of one of the white supremacist groups that's an actual federal agent, Elohim City, McVeigh, the rest of them, that came out in federal court. And the people under them running around heiling Hitler don't even know they're being handled by the Southern Poverty Law Center. That came out in federal court. I mean, I've gone out and protested the Klan, and you could take one look at the leader of the groups, and I'll say, you're a big fat federal agent. And the guy says, I'll kill you, and doesn't get in trouble. That happened up in Waco. There's video of that. The Second Amendment means I can kill whoever I want. That's a fad to demonize the Second Amendment. And that ended up being in the newspaper, the Waco paper at the time. I told you Hal Turner was an FBI operative. Turned out he was above FBI, assigned to the FBI as a, quote, national security asset, and the federal court in Chicago sealed what federal agency he works for. CIA, probably. And by the way, when Anonymous blew his cover and released all his info, They burned him. You notice that. So what am I getting at here? This is the divide and conquer. It's not that the Russians are good. It's not that Putin's good. It's that the West, George Soros, NATO, initiated this 3.5 months ago when they didn't vote to join the EU, overthrew the country, because Russia was coming in with